حلو عيو الله كريم.
هاي ام شيرة رمضان from Jerusalem.
Hi, this is Iman Bilbaisi from Gaza.
Hi, I'm Ala Khayo from Jerusalem.
Hi, I'm Farah Abu Qasim living in Gaza.
Hi, this is Diana Zir from Ramallah.
My name is Nagam Mhanna. I live in Gaza.
أعزائي المستمعين نقدم لكم نشرة الأخبار.
I am Yara Al-Amla. I'm living in Ramallah.
I'm here in near Yaffa, in between Yaffa and Tel Aviv, and I'm here at the National Center for Forensic Medicine. It's known as Abu Kabir. It's where the body of Ra'ed Abu Hamad is being kept. He's the guy who was killed in prison, and I think you saw his family yesterday with Diana. So I'm here to try and get to talk to the lawyer and the doctor. There's a Palestinian lawyer and doctor who are coming to participate in the autopsy. So I'm here to try and catch them and talk to them a bit. So I'm just gonna wait for them here.
So today I'm back to Ra'ed Abu Hamad's house to see his family again. They're expecting the body today. كيفك موسى؟ شو أخبارك؟ إيش أنت رح يوصل الجثمان؟
الجثمان مش عارفين لحد هلا، بس حكوا لنا الدكتور والمحامي إنه احتمال يسلموهم إياه بعد الساعة 4 العصر.
I asked him about when are they gonna get the body, and he said they don't know exactly yet. But the lawyer and the doctor told them that they will probably give them the body after 4 p.m. كيف صارت العملية؟
لحد هلا ما أعطونا ولا خبر كيف صارت العملية أو شو السبب، شو التقرير لسه مش طالع 100%.
They don't know exactly.
أو معهم خبر ما خبرونا.
Or he suspects that they probably know and they still didn't tell them. طب انت بتعرف اخوك، يعني عشت معه عمر طويل، بينك وبين حالك ما بتتوقع ايش السبب؟ انه يعني
السبب 100% الاحتلال، يعني سبب وفاة اخي
الاحتلال.
كل المسؤولية على الاحتلال
is occupation. يعني انت بتتوقع انه الاحتلال قتل اخوك؟
بالضبط.
He believes 100% that the occupation actually killed his brother. طب بس انا امبارح ما عرفت رائد ليش تحديدا انسجن او ايش السبب.
كان فايت على القدس بدون تسريح.
He was going to Jerusalem without permit.
مرفوض امني وتمشكل مع جندي.
And because of security reasons he got into a small clash with a soldier on the checkpoint.
واتهموه بتهمة شروع بالقتل.
And because of that they sent him to jail and thinking that he was actually wanting to kill the soldier. يعني هو ما حاول يقتل الجندي، بس هو
صار شجار بينه وبين الجندي، بس ما حاول انه ما اذى الجندي.
Yeah, because of the small clash or the small fight that happened between him and the soldier who didn't allow him to go into Jerusalem, because of that he was actually sent to jail. واخوك اياد امتى بقدر احكي معه؟ ولا هو كمان
بالعزا؟
بالعزا.
كنت تروحوا عليه هناك تقدر تصور.
I'm asking about the older brother اياد. اياد هو اللي متواصل معنا.
نعم متواصل معنا.
Because اياد is the older brother and he's the one in touch with the lawyer and the doctor. And they're obviously not here. They're at the male funeral house.
Okay, هلا you're gonna go in?
Yeah.
Okay, so this is the doctor who's gonna perform the autopsy with them. And he's in a hurry, so he's gonna go into the. Dr. Sabir Al-Arun is going to go in and we'll talk to him after the autopsy or in... Did I just leave?
No.
No, you can't.
Yeah.
Okay. And we'll see you then outside.
Yeah, okay.
Okay. Thank you. They actually they will search the doctor here when he goes in.
But can you tell us, like, why is it, like, you're here to make sure that they won't, like, take any parts of the body and not the autopsy suffering? Why are you going to perform? Why are you going to take part of it? ليش بدك تشارك في
بدي شارك؟ هذا سؤال يعني very important عشان
He's basically saying that he needs to do this. He knows to know the mechanism and the reason for death and the mechanism of death. So now they take him for further search.
So I've asked Mucha to take me to the funeral house where all the men are there, and we're going to meet Iyad, his older brother, who's in touch with the lawyer and the doctor.
I'm with the family, and they said they got a phone call, and maybe in like 15 minutes they will receive the body. Yeah, Musa's here. Hey, Ashira.
Hello.
This was Ashira, and she's
Ashira.
She's with the doctor and the lawyer
at the Forensics Institute.
From Kiev.
Kiev? ماشي مس. ماشي توكل على الله ماشي.
إيش؟
بدي ترجع للتلفون لسه مش م.
تخلص
أوراق ضاير. نخلصوا الأوراق.
They're just finishing documents before the release of the body.
خلصوا التشريح يعني جاهزين التشريح ما مخلصين.
The Forensics Institute just finished whatever they had to do, and they're just finishing a couple of documents before the release of the body. طيبو اسمعت تحكي إشي أمبولانسات
أكيد إنها بدها تطلع في الأمبولانس التاني وما بتجيبوا أمبولانس إسرائيلي وسلمونا إياه على دوار معالي أدومين.
They will bring the body in an Israeli ambulance, and at the front gate or the front entrance to the Azariya town, there's going to be an exchange between ambulances. They will exchange, they will move the body from one ambulance, the Israeli one, to the Palestinian one, waiting at the gate of Azariya.
So this is the lawyer, Tariq Barghouti, and he's the lawyer with the Palestinian Prisoners Ministry, and he's the one who arranged for me to come today. شكراً عشان ساعدتني اليوم. هلا بدي أسألك ليش وزارة الأسرة بعتتكم أنت وكمان الدكتور؟ I'm asking why the ministry, the Palestinian Prisoners Ministry, sent both of them today here to Abu Kabir to the autopsy.
اللي صار بالضبط إنه 16 شهر شهر جاري توفى أو استشهد الأسير رائد أبو حماد من قرية العزرية، وخلال تقضية فترة العقوبة اللي هي 10 سنين، هو قضى منها 5 سنين، والخمس سنين هذول كان منهم 2.5 سنين بسجن الانفرادي.
What happened is on the 16th of May this on the 16th of What happens is on the 16th of this month, the Palestinian prisoner, Ra'id Abu Hamad, died in prison. He's a martyr, and he was spending his 10-year prison time, and he spent only 5 of them, and then he died in prison. He was in solitary confinement for 2.5 years. وهل انت هل يعني عملية التشريح والجثة لأن دائما بتصير ولا لأنه في خوف انه في اشي غلط صار بالسجن؟
هلا
I'm asking him if the autopsy always occur, like they always do this process, or is it because there is this doubt that something happened.
هلا احنا يعني خلال تعاملنا مع الواقع هذا نجحنا ان نستخرج قرار من المحكمة الإسرائيلية ببير السبع إنه يكون موجود باثولوج، يعني بيكون موجود طبيب شرعي من قبلنا، من قبل العائلة ومن قبل برضو وزارة الأسرة، اللي يشرف على عملية التشريح ويشارك فيها. أول شيء من أجل إنه ما يتلاعبوا بنتائج التشريح، ثاني شيء من أجل يعني الحفاظ على الأعضاء الداخلية للشهيد، الأعضاء الداخلية للشهيد، وإحنا بنعرف إنه فترة مش بعيدة تم يعني تم فضح موضوع سرقة الأعضاء البشرية لسجناء ولا شهداء فلسطينيين.
Okay, so what they've done, and as the as the Palestinian prisoner ministry, and they as lawyers, they went to the magistrate's court and they said that if the, an autopsy is going to happen, we want a member, like we want a member of the Palestinian forensic experts to be there, to be present at the autopsy and to take part in the autopsy. The reason why they do this, as he says, is because that they want to make sure that there isn't any that they won't change or alter any of the results of the autopsy, and that the results will not be manipulated. And also, he says, because very recently there has been a case, a scandal which was revealed that in this هي هاي الفضيحة صارت بأبو كبير اكتشفوا إنه في سرقة الأعضاء. The scandal was that in Abu Kabir, in this forensic institute, and in other Israeli forensic institutes, the doctors have been stealing, harvesting body parts, Palestinian body parts, from martyrs and from other Palestinian Palestinian bodies, and they have been selling it and using it. فلهذا السبب أنتم موجودين. هلا هاي أول مرة بتصير إنه بشارك فلسطيني ولا كيف؟ أنا مش عارفة. أنت مفروض تكون عندك أكثر. I asked if this is the first time that there's a Palestinian doctor who participates in the process.
نحكي إن هي من المرات النادرة جدا. بس هذا الإشي جاء بعد ما ادعت سلطة السجون إنه هذا الشهيد سبب وفاته انتحار. وهذا الحكي إحنا مش بنعهده بالسجناء الأمنيين تبعونا. سجناءنا الأمنيين والسياسيين الفلسطينيين ما في يعني ما في قبل هيك حوادث انتحار، لأنهم هم داخلين بعد يعني دخلوا على السجون بعد ما كان في عندهم قرار معين وإرادة معينة إنهم يواجهوا الاحتلال وإلى آخره، ففي شك كبير في المسألة يعني.
So he says the reason the Palestinian doctor is taking part in this autopsy, it's very rare. It's one of the very unusual times that the Palestinian doctor is allowed into the autopsy room. And this is because the Israeli prisoner authority is claiming that Ra'ed committed suicide. And what he's saying is this is something that the Palestinian authority is against, and the Palestinian prisoner ministry is refuting. And they say that it's this is not something that is common between Palestinian prisoners, especially political prisoners, because they go into prison with the conviction, and the reasons they go into prison because they have conviction to fight the occupation, and because they're defending their rights. So it's not common, it hasn't happened before, that Palestinian prisoners did commit suicide, and this is why they want a proper autopsy. ما صارت من قبل انه انتحر عنا.
لا انا بحكي انه مش يعني انا ما حكيتش انه هذه مش عادي.
لا انه انتحار.
انا حكيت انه ما في حوادث انتحار.
We didn't have any cases of like Palestinian prisoners committing suicide. طب هن كيف حكوا كيف صار انه انتحار كيف هو بعزل ما هو الشاب. I'm saying how did he commit suicide? He's in solitary confinement.
بتعرفي انت يعني
حكوا شنق مثلا ولا حكوا السقيف؟
بتعرفي انت انه السجانين طبعا بدلوا بالشهادات القديمه، طبعا ما فيش شهود من الطرف المقابل لانه هذا زي ما حكيت سجن وسجن انفرادي.
He says that the prison guards can give their statements whatever they are. There's no one to refute them and they're in prison and there wasn't anyone with him to say it, so that there's no one to fight his battle for him. بس ايش حكوا؟ What did they say? Like, was it? Did he hang himself? Did he? كيف حكوا؟
لسه لحد فترة ما أعطوا سبب أو طريقة الانتحار.
They haven't given a reason or
أنا بشوف إنه بعد لا عليهم بفكروا بطريقة معينة.
He thinks that right now they're actually coming up and thinking of what they're gonna say and how he killed himself, how he committed suicide.
مرحبا.
مين الحمد لله.
This is Iyad, Ra'ed's older brother. أنت اللي عم تحكي هلا مع الدكتور والمحامي صح؟
أنا بحكي.
إيش آخر الأخبار اللي وصلتكم؟ He's in touch with the lawyer and the doctor. I'm asking him what are the recent things that he received from them.
مبدئياً عملية التشريح تمت على الانتهاء. بنستنى إنه
الإجراءات تخلص حتى يتم تحميله في أمبولانس.
The whole process, they said it's finished and we're waiting as the call that I received that some missing documents need to be finished and then the transfer through ambulances will happen.
في جميع الأحوال يعني أنا في جميع الأحوال بحمل المسؤولية لقوات الاحتلال.
Either way, I blame Israeli soldiers of the death of my brother.
مرحبا يعطيك العافية دكتور. So can you tell me how was it?
Everything was okay. الوضع كان كثير مهني والتشريح كان بطريقة مهنية عالية. لكن أي معلومات طبية شرعية ما بنقدر نحكي عنها للإعلام إلا عن طريق وزير الأسرة.
It has to go through the Ministry of Prisoners. So you said that you can't tell me any information if it's of what happened inside. But can you at least tell me if it's suicide?
بالنسبة للانتحار ما في أي علاقة في جثمان الشهيد إنه يكون منتحر أو أي طريقة من أنواع الانتحار.
He says that there isn't under any circumstances on the body any proof that there was suicide. So يعني مش موت طبيعي برضو. Is it natural death? I'm asking.
ما بقدر أجاوب ولا أي جواب بس أنا بحكي ما له علاقة بأي انتحار.
He says he can't answer us and give us the details, but it doesn't have it. It's not related. It's not suicide. So he's yeah. طب وهلا يعني هلا بنستنى الجثة. لا الجثة. أنا بحكي على الجثة. I'm asking about the body. When will the body be given to you? You said that you want to check it afterwards, صح?
Yeah.
Okay.
أنا عملت تشيك عملية فحص كامل وكشف كامل.
They did do the check, especially.
الأعضاء كلها بمحلها وما تم أي أخذ أي أعضاء.
He says that all the body parts.
وتحديدا القرنيات.
Especially the. قرنية إيش بالإنجليزي؟
ما هو كورنية.
The cornea of the eye hasn't been. ليش هو في شك هنا دائما بياخدو؟
شك هيك اللي معروف كان.
He says what's known that the Israelis usually take the a part of the eye, the cornea.
The cornea
of the eye. So they check that this hasn't happened.
إحنا كمان دورنا كطب شرعي نحافظ على جثمان الشهيد وإنه ما يتم أخذ أي عضو. من الأعضاء جثمان الشهيد.
He says as forensic experts their duty is to check that not any body part has been harmed, like has been taken or harvested, and that the autopsy goes in proper manners. Okay, هلا حنستنى
الجثمان.
We're just now gonna wait for the body, but a few minutes, and then I need to call the family because Diana's with the family, and I need to tell them what's happening and update them on everything. Can I ask you, الشغلك اللي تسلم تات أو أسوه بخلال؟ أبل شنية كي نحن هولخيم أخريخم برخف אז תחכו שנייה עד שאנחנו נצא במכוניות. אפשר?
אני נוסע.
כן, אני מבינה, אבל רק
שתחכו. אני לא יכול לעצור.
I'm just asking them to wait for us for three minutes.
לך אני ניסיתי להתקשר עכשיו.
למה?
כדי להגיע לך איפה אני פוגש את המשפחה.
מה?
אני פוגש את המשפחה בכניסה לבעלי.
זה הוא?
Oh, هذا الامبولانس اللي معاه هذا. This is the ambulance that's holding him. I'm calling Diana now. Hello, hi Diana. Okay, I'm now with the ambulance. They're not letting us film inside the ambulance and I don't think they will wait for us, so we have to hurry. But you can tell the family that the ambulance is moving. It's not on the way. It's in 5 minutes. It will be on its way. Yeah. It's in Abu Kabir in Tel Aviv, Yafa. All right. So almost an hour and a half.
Okay, I have to go. I have to go now. بعد قبل ما علي أدميم لأنه العيلة حتى بتقدرش توصل للمنطقة هذه.
لا لا ما
لا تصل. لا. سيارة إسعاف بس مش العيلة. So I was asking them who's gonna be there and where are we, where's the point where the other ambulance is gonna come, and it seems like they're gonna switch between like one ambulance and the other, the Israeli and the Palestinian, in Ma'ale Adumim. Hello.
Hi, Ashira.
Hi, Diana.
Do you have any news?
Yeah, I'm now following them. I'm just gonna put you on speaker. I'm following them on. We're now, I think, in Modi'in, near Modi'in settlement.
Again, I can't hear you.
Okay, we're on Modi'in settlement. I'm following the ambulance and the car.
You're
which
following the ambulance with your own car on the highway.
Yeah, yeah,
okay.
Exactly. And yeah, hopefully we're gonna be there. I think in an hour because the ambulance is going, of course, very fast.
Oh, the ambulance is coming really fast. Okay. So you need 1 hour to get here.
Yeah, I got the chance to talk to the doctor, but there's an issue
with the doctor. Okay. And yeah, what is it? What's the reason for his death?
After the autopsy, he said there's an issue with telling the press because the Palestinian Ministry of Prisoners wants to get all the details before they speak.
Okay.
But the only thing I can tell you so far is that they ruled out suicide. Which is the Israelis?
What?
They ruled out suicide. The first thing the Israelis were saying that he killed himself in prison.
Okay, so he did not kill himself in prison.
Yeah, yeah. The doctor. That's the only thing he could assure me, and he could tell me is that it wasn't suicide. Seems like there's.
It wasn't suicide. Okay.
Yeah. But don't tell the family. I think it's better they know. You know.
No, I'm not gonna tell the family.
Anyways, are you at the house now? The funeral house. Do you know who's?
The funeral house, no.
Okay, so do you know who's gonna go out to meet the body?
I don't know. We'll figure out now.
Okay. Anyways, we're okay. Just tell the family that we're on our way. We're.
Yeah, they already know. They already know and told them.
Yeah. Okay. Good. Okay. All right. I'll see you. Okay. I'll see you there.
Thank you, Ashira. Bye.
Bye.
To Ra'ed's family's house again because in about an hour they will receive the body inside the house, so I'm going this way to the house.
بس رح يجيبوا الثمان لهون عشان انتوا تودعوا بس اهله
اول اهله فهم خواته فهم كيف عماته
وخالاته father and they will bring the body here for the sisters and the brothers to say goodbye to the body and then
بعد ما يودعوا فهم كيف نحمله من هون على عند الزلام
and then برضو. They will move it to the male funeral house
برضو يشوفوا اخوته واهله وقرايبه هناك يودعوه وبعدين هناك يطلعوا
for the rest of family and relatives and then they will take him to
على اخر مقر له ان شاء الله على القبر تبعه
to bury him. وصلني خبر انكم مدعوين تروحوا تشوفوا ابو مازن رحت؟
اي نعم
رحت
اي نعم حسب بيقول انه يعني عزيني.
Today he went to the presidency to meet with the president, the Palestinian president ابو مازن.
الحمد لله وتقابلنا انا وياه وقعدنا انا وياه فاهم كيف؟ وساني يعني في الجرح والالم اللي معي. مو يعني مش انا ابو العلا ابن الشعب كله ابن الرئيس كله يعني مش انا ابوه لحاله يعني فاهم كيف كل الشعب الفلسطيني ابوه والرئيس ابوه فاهم كيف فالحمد لله رب العالمين ادى الرئيس الواجب اللي عليه فاهم كيف
he's not only his son but he's the son of all Palestinians and even the son of the president and we thank the president for all his support and of course he was very supportive
بدنا ننقل الجثة هون ليش بدنا نعمل شو الفحص اللي بدنا نتأكد منه اللي هو فحص شو اسمه القرنيات انه بالفراغ اللي صار عندنا انه الساعة انه ما صار في اي اخذ لاي قرنيات هذا الفحص الاخير والنهائي
in this half hour that the body was with them we need to check that nothing has happened.
دكتور هلا is there an actual danger that they have they could have done something in the
ambulance؟ طلع بس بدي افحص على العينين على السريع.
Just wants to check in seconds just the eyes.
خالد علي انو حكى بده لا لا لا
هذيك شو معك معك
عالمي اياد بس انا شو بتكفل
ايوه خلص خلص افتح الباب افتح الباب
اياد اياد فتح من اسمك
لف بالعالم
ايش هيك كم يوصل الدور
محمد حتطلع على البيت او
ايوه انت بدك
تسمكوش
بعد احنا لا في كاميرا اوريدي هناك واحنا حنطلع معكم ان
شاء الله على اوقاف على اوقاف
لا
على الدار اذا في كاميرا في الدار
في كاميرا في البيت
خلص انتوا على اوقاف
وين الاوقاف
مدى سليتها
وزارة الأوقاف
احنا
بارك الله
خليني بس يوري العلم
اوكي
يا طارق
نقدر نطلع معكم
حسبي الله ونعم الوكيل ايوه قاعد كويس
اسمع خيرك زين حد حطه وش اللي
في السرير فيش حطه
انا رايح على نفسه
لا يرحمك يا اخوي بعد 5 سنين نشوفك شوفك شهيد شوفك شهيد يا
فرح لي
يا نيالك يا اخوي الله يفرح وين كنت اللي انا وين
كنت منور
يا كنت اللي هنا وينك
حسبي الله
ونعم الوكيل
خطها خليها بطيح دار
طيب كيف بقوله فيش اشي عاوز
شوي طبشينا
اسمع
في اشي على جسمه
مبين طبشينا اخوات الشرموطه
you can see there's marks on his body that they have beaten up you can see on his body
كل جسمه ردود
his whole body is filled with marks that he has been beaten up
افتح الزمور وادخل على العزرية
طيب خلص طيب نعد كوش يا جماعة
الو هاي طلعنا في الامبولانس يلا خمسك يا
طيني يا
شو ايوه خش على الضحية
We're now in the ambulance and his they can tell that there's marks on his body that he has been beaten up and that they have tortured him.
الضحية على علاء
يا زلمة دروك طلع عليك دروك تدري وش الزلمة
خلاص روح توكل مالك
خلاص روح
صور اللي بدك اياه توكل على الله خليها يا سيدي تصير معي مع شيء ابو حسن جاب جيجي وما في يتحرك ايوه ورانا ابو حسن ايوه شوف صحتك شوف كلها
والله صحتك
والله
على اخوي
كلك صحتك والله اكفحل اشد انك فحل يا اخوي بطل صحتك بطل صحتك
they're saying that his health Everything was fine with him and he's healthy and his body is... هلا بحكي للبنات يجيبوا حط
موجود خلص يلا طلعت خلص السلام عليكم حذر طيح على طيح على طرف اخوي محمود وعلى الجبل حذر الجبل
اسمعي انت وير ار يو ار يو ات ذا فاميلي هاوس
ماشي لا لا طيحت على الدار انا طيح اسبقني على الدار تعال على الدار يلا بسرعه 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 تطولش لا لا تعال لحالك بسرعة
انت وين اول محل رح توقف وين رح توقف
عالدار عالدار
عالدار
عالدار
هاي
حاتم
هاي
وسلم
منطقة هاي دخل
هاي نص عدينا الدوار
اه اه سلام الله يرحمك اه هاي ملفوف ملفوف معلم
اوه يا
زلمه روح
بس
بسم
الله
الرحمن الرحيم
بس
غطي راسه لا اله الا الله اه روسه بس 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 هيو هيو هلا هيو قبل ما ننزل عند اهله حيوقفوا على المفرح هذا يعطي مد
حسبي الله ونعم الوكيل
شفت علم صغير انا وينه اعطيني العلم الصغير من تحت غطي راسه يا شيخ
ايوه تغطي راسه كله ولا
لا لا بس عشان في وضع اوضاع
هاي عمليه اختيال هاي عمليه اختيال رسميه هذا عمليه اختيال
this is an assassination in the
زلزالات منفرد عمليه
in solitary confinement this is
قوات الاحتلال بتختار
اسوانا لا حول ولا قوه our soldiers people who have no one to protect them they're killing him he says look at his face his whole face
هيك كل جسم
بالسبيسن
هيك راسه مرة متورم من الضرب
شوي 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 سنسن بضلك نازل تطعم الشكة الثانية فيه وفيه فيه طريق سهلة
بيك برا
أيوة أنا أطير
شوي 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 شوي
بكرا نهان
نهان
ماشي ماشي في الامبولانس
لفين بتفتح الامبولانس
لا ولا باب تفتح بالامبولانس صح
بس نلف بس داخل نلف ونشفنا
تحت نقطه فيها طلعه ثانيه مخوف شوي
اسمع
انا بعرف بس قصدي اذا قولهم بس
لو سمحتي خليه يعطي نبيل عماها خلي مهدي يجينا على الباب علاء خليه يجيبوا له الشفن
وين الشفن اعطيني الشفن اعطيني الشفن ايش الولد استنى شوي
الشفن الشفن
اعطيني الشفن
مع مينو
مع محمد هات الشفن قلت لك جيبه
هو ودوه على الدار ودوه
هات الشفن ساعة نحكي معه يلا هيا روح يجيبه شوي شوي شوي
شوي شوي شوي شوي شوي ولا واحد يطلع عمار ولا واحد يطلع دقايق بدنا نطيح عنكم تودعوه بدنا نطيح كلهم بدنا يطيحوا عنكم ثواني
Oh, Sheila, tamam. How are you? Tell me. Did you see the body?
Yeah. I'm still shaking because it's... The family saw him for the first time and they were very emotional. And I'm kind of emotional because you see his face and it's like bright. Because they say, you know, a martyr's face is bright. But there's signs on his face that he's been beaten up and on his body, so
So this is yeah. They're kind of trying to wrap him up now so that the mother doesn't get to see him like this. But yeah, definitely not a suicide. He's not like a weak person.
Yeah,
or something.
Yeah, yeah. He's a karate trainer.
Yeah, no, he's even bigger than he was when they last saw him.
Wow. Is there bruises on his face?
Yeah, there's a bruise on his head.
واحنا بنواصل كيفاه واحنا بنواصل الشهيد والمسامحة له، والتكبيرة الرابعة الدعاء لنا وللمسلمين. استقيموا إلى الصلاة. الله أكبر،
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر،
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر،
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر،
الله أكبر.
Women are not to go into the cemetery, are not allowed to go into the cemetery while they're burying someone, so we're just going to wait here.
يا جماعة في المجال، يا جماعة في المجال يا أخوان.
لا إله إلا الله،
لا إله إلا الله.
الشهيد حبيب الله،
الشهيد حبيب الله، لا إله إلا الله.
هناك حبيب الله، لا إله إلا الله.
الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر.